I had to win at everything I did. Well, this time I failed and I knew it. See, I failed to tell him about my friend. Not only my friend, but my Savior. I forgot to tell him a little something. That's when I started the blame game. I didn't blame God. I didn't blame my friends. I didn't blame anybody except myself. I was blaming myself for a decision that he would have had to make in his own heart. Would he have made that decision? I don't know. I started blaming myself by saying, hey, was it my fault? Was I the reason that this guy may not be in heaven? Did I just commit the sin of silence? Was I the cause of sending someone else to hell without even meaning to do it? The guilt hung over my head for so long, and yet I just didn't know what to do. I started asking questions. Am I really supposed to feel this way? Why do I feel so bad about something that I'm not even 100% positive about? Could he be in heaven? Could he be in hell? Would the result have been my fault? Maybe Daniel was saved and I didn't even know about it. Questions just kept coming. The burden was getting heavier and heavier. Till one morning I woke up before class. On that morning it was hot. I decided to get up and go for a run. When I got back, took a shower, got on my knees, hands and knees in the dorm room floor, I prayed and I asked God. I said, God, why do I feel this way? Why do I feel so guilty about this whole situation? It felt like at that moment, God started talking to me. He said, open up my word. At that moment, I grabbed my Bible, opened it up. And in my Bible, it wasn't a scripture that spoke to me. See, there was this little lesson up in Genesis on chapter 3, I believe it was, and what it said was that how Satan works. It was a guide that revealed every little detail on how Satan will attack us. The first thing it showed was that Satan makes you doubt and question God's word and his goodness. See, in Daniel's situation, I started questioning what God had been doing in my own life because I wasn't sure about Daniel anymore. The next step showed how Satan will discourage us and make us look at our own problems rather than focus on God. See, when Daniel died, I began to focus on whether or not he was saved or not. See, now it was something that I couldn't control, but yet now I wasn't going and witnessing to other people because I was so guilty. I was feeling so guilty about not telling Daniel. The last lesson that it showed me is how Satan makes us feel defeated. Like I said, I was a person who couldn't take failure. I didn't accept it. To this day, I'm not good at it. But he makes us all feel like we fail so that we won't even try. At that moment, I broke down and realized that I'd allowed Satan to trick me. The whole time I was blaming myself, I wasn't spreading God's word along with other people because I was too busy feeling sorry for myself. That's when it hit me. God was in the middle of it all. Through the tough situation, through all the tears, there was a lot of good that was able to come from it. God showed me through such a tough experience how Satan will attack us when we're most vulnerable. He'll make us feel like failures, but that's when God stepped in to show me that no matter how Satan makes you feel, that my Lord and my Savior was there to pick me up. Now when I get a chance, I'm going to take the time to speak to a friend and show him how Christ has changed my life. Since that time, I've been able to work in 6 months as a youth pastor at a local church near my school. I'm no longer afraid to tell someone about the greatest man who's ever walked this earth. I'm happy to tell everybody who my King is. Thank you, Jesus, for saving my soul.